Now let's continue.
자, 여기서 이제 이런 게 나옵니다. 사단의 앞잡이들은 병을 고칠 수 있다고 주장한다. 사실 그들은
Evangelism, Book Evangelism 609. These satanic agents claim to cure disease. They attribute their power to electricity, magnetism, or the so-called sympathetic remedies. While in truth they are but channels for Satan's electric currents.
자기 자신들의 힘이 전기와 체면술과 소위 체면치료라는
By this means he casts his spell over the bodies and souls of men.
야, 나한테 와라. 문제 없어.
So those agents, they say, yeah, come to me, I can do everything. So they glorify themselves. Signs of the Times, March 24. So when Ellen G. White talks about this electric current, this is very specific. Theology itself cannot explain all those things. Now, when Ellen G. White speaks about this, this is the spiritual level. The satanic electric current, as we can call false healing. So there is false healing and true healing. Let's say you get better, and then you can't, just because you get better, you can't say you got healed by God. There are many ways to get better. Sister White says there are so many healing arts in this world. But God approves just the word of God. God approves just one healing. That's from that healing is from the word of God. Medical Ministry 14. For Satan will exercise his power by working miracles. God's servants today could not work by means of miracles because superior works of healing claiming to be divine will be wrought. This I experienced. You know, remember I told you before I laid my hand and miraculously my patient got hurt. I mean healed, got better. You know, remember when I prayed, I saw this spark or the light in the air. I think that's the light from Satan. I was novice in the church. I didn't know the Bible. But I asked God to give me this blessings of healing. Let's say, you know, 9-year-old boy asked his daddy to buy him autobi. You know, and then, of course, his father didn't buy him this auto bicycle, but then the neighbor, this man, one of the neighbors, he bought it for the son. But then my father stopped him to buy this and so forth. That's kind of comparison I used before. But anyways, I asked God to give me these blessings of healing. And somehow so and so happened, like I said before, God stopped me performing this false healing when I kept begging him to give me these blessings of healing.
So, 이 때문에 보세요. 참, 이게 선지자입니다.
Now, Ellen G. White's writing, continue medical ministry. For this reason, the Lord has marked out a way in which His people are to carry forward a work of physical healing combined with the teaching of the Word. That's the biology. This is provided for the last remnant church. And this is what we should do in this time. You know, I want you guys to know, you know, you pastors should know this truth and preach this to your church and the people around this world. You know, pastors, you need to remind this truth to your church members. This writing is not in the level of theology only, but it's in the level of spiritual prophet. I'm so sure that she is the prophet from God. Theologically, I don't know how to say that she is, if she's a prophet or not, but regarding the Word of God, and regarding the disease, and regarding the spiritual things, she is, I'm so sure that she is a prophet. False healing is from the satanic electric current, but the true healing is from God's electric current, which is the spiritual, the Word of God in the spiritual level. Now, 27 Fundamental Doctrines, page 80. When God changed the elements of earth into a living being, He breathed the breath of life into the nostrils of Adam's lifeless body. This breath of life is the breath of the Almighty that gives life, the spark of life. We might compare it with the streams of electricity. When we turn on the TV, you know, TV's on and the pictures are all on the screen. The electricity brings sound and motion where once there was nothing. That was in 27 Fundamental Doctrines, page 82. There's a very specific answer and explanation. You know, the woman in the crowd had suffered for 12 years with constant bleeding. That was Mark 5:25. You know, this lady wanted to go to Jesus. Do you know what motivated her to go to Jesus? This lady heard of Jesus.
자, 여러분, 예수의 소문 안 듣는 사람이 어디?
And then she wanted to go to Jesus. You know, at that time, around that time, everybody heard of Jesus. But the Bible, why did the Bible say that she heard of Jesus and she wanted to go to Jesus and touch His robe?
Oh. 생각하게 되냐 말입니다. 그게 중요합니다. 무슨 소문, 예수에 대한 자 이번에 지금 가만 들어보니까
What kind of story did she hear?
비싸다 이런 소문이 있는 거예요.
You know, there is gossip that, you know, you have to pay me a lot to invite me to have the seminar. This is also the story or the gossip. Now, what kind of story did this lady hear? What motivated her to go to Jesus and touch his robe to get healed?
그 소문 때문에 그 여인은 예수 그리스도의 예수 그리스도를 어떻게 해요? 믿게 됐죠.
Because of that story that she heard, she became to trust Jesus. So when you hear this kind of story, you just can't overlook.
예수의 소문을 듣고 아, 그랬구나. 소문을 듣고 가야죠.
You need to listen to this story carefully.
그 당시 혈루병, 중풍, 문둥병 이거 다 하나님이 뭐
You know, constant bleeding or lepers and those paralyzed, stroke, those kind of disease are all punished by God. At the time, that was what they were thinking. If you constantly bleed and you know you're filthy and so you cannot get married, so you're like cursed. So she thought she was punished by God. Now, worst patient was the lepers.
Leprosy, lep, 문둥병 환자들을 leper라고 부릅니다. L-E-P-E-R, leper라고 부릅니다. Lep라는 말은 채찍으로 맞았다는 뜻입니다.
Lepers means you're stripped. You're whipped. Because you know your nerves, they're very long. They're all through your body. You know, because your nerves are long, they think when you have this leprosy, they say you are whipped.
중풍은 우리가 스트로크라고 하죠. Strike.
And then paralyzed, that is also called stroke. Stroke, the original meaning of stroke is like you're struck by something. So here, who struck these patients? God struck these patients. That's why they feel like they have this stroke. So she thought she was cursed by God. But one day she heard that Jesus touched this leper. You cannot touch the lepers, but Jesus touched the lepers to get healed. You know, people are not supposed to touch these lepers because they are cursed. And you cannot even get close to them. But then Jesus touched the lepers. And she said, you know, Jesus touched lepers? Really? He really touched the lepers? Yeah, he really touched the lepers and he got healed. And she was shocked. And to her, that is such a great news. It's not just the gossip, or it's not the story that she can be interested in. This is just the shock. While she's in the same situation, centurion's servant got healed. How? Just the word. Jesus just said the word.
유명한 유대인 그 당시 유대인들에게는 백부장이라면 아주 증오의 대상.
Well, in those times, centurions are hated by Jewish people.
들어가인,
and when we talk about this centurion's servants, then those servants, even Jewish people don't want to mention about. But Jesus, he said he wanted to go and heal him. But then the centurion said, well, Jesus, Lord, just say the word. So Jesus said, well, go to your house and see. And then the centurion went home and the servants got healed. So this story touched this lady greatly. Jesus heals people whoever they are. Then this Jesus must be God or even higher than God. Why? Because he can heal these sick who are cursed by God. I need this man. I've been to so many doctors all this time, but they couldn't help me. My symptoms got worse, even though I went to the doctors. And I am broke now. I need Jesus. I need Him. Jesus loved the leper and touched the leper. Then if I just touch his robe, even though I touch his robe, he wouldn't be upset because he loved the leper. It'll be okay for me to touch his robe. Now this woman already received the Spirit of Christ. So the crowds are all around Jesus, following him, but she got through the crowd. She had this power to get through. Excuse me, let me get through, let me get through. I need to touch his robe. Jesus was heading toward where? Do you know where? He was going to Jairus. Now Jairus was the leader of the church, and you know this great man, leader of the church, came to Jesus and said, my daughter is ill, so please come and take care of my daughter. Now this leader of the church said, please come to my house and lay your hand on my daughter. But this cursed woman, she's thinking that if I just touch his robe, I will be healed. Now you can see the contrary of the faith. When she goes toward Jesus, Jesus would think, okay, woman, come, come, come to me. And the crowds go, hey, what happened? Hey, excuse you. But then she would say, I'm sorry, excuse me, let me get through. You know, the crowd, they follow Jesus, but then the crowd, they didn't want to have serious relationship with God. Not like this lady, this woman. Let's say the church, the crowds are the church members. Hey, don't get too deep into religion. People sometimes say, well, you don't have to try that hard to touch his robe. Things like that. I've heard a lot of these kind of things before. Hey, do the doctor's job, practice your clinic, and offer your offerings to church. You know, have an easy religious life. There are so many crowds like that around me before. But me, I couldn't satisfy. If I do something, I want it to do seriously, perfectly. Jesus prayed. Well, that's what the Spirit of Prophecy said. Yeah, Sister Wright wrote. Jesus knew what this woman wanted, so Jesus prayed for this lady. Why? Because the Spirit was connected. Well, the life Spirit was connected. When Nathanael prayed, and he also said, what can good come from the Galilee? But then Nathanael said, well, I saw you praying under the fig tree. You know, Nathanael prayed to God, and that is saying, Jesus is saying, God, that is me. You told me to come, Nathanael. Nathanael, you prayed. You wanted to meet the true Messiah. That is me, Nathanael. The other day, you prayed under that fig tree. So when Jesus said, when you prayed under the fig tree, then at that very moment, the Spirit was connected. Nathanael is saying, God, the gospel that the church is teaching, that I don't think that's the truth. God, please show yourself. God, I want to see the true Messiah. I think it's about time for the Messiah to come. And then Jesus is speaking, well, you told me to come, and I am here before you. And then Nathanael said, wow, you are the Son of God. You know, this kind of relationship in the true Spirit, that relationship is teaching, is taught in the Bible. It's not about just a knowledgeable level. It's the spiritual level that the Bible is teaching us. Now this woman touched his robe, and that moment she knew that she was healed. In that one touch was concentrated the faith of a life, and instantly her pain and feebleness disappeared. Instantly she felt a thrill as of an electric current passing through every fiber of her being. Well, this Sister White could write is because she herself experienced this electric current. There came over her sensation of perfect health. She felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. This writing is taken from Ministry of Healing, page 60. You know, she was bleeding, constantly bleeding, and maybe she had problems in her womb, and maybe she would feel this heat in her womb. She felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. Now, Sister White understood this not in the factual level, but the spiritual level, energy level. She touched his robe and she got healed in not like this way. Not like the water from the Yosemite National Park. It's just not the water from the rocks. It's not that kind of level of understanding. We should understand this in a spiritual level.
Now,
This writing is from Ellen White's writing, and there's no quotation, but this Ellen White experienced by herself. She experienced the electric current of God in her body. Here she says, she was in the worship service and she felt very weak, but she felt this Spirit of God, and I felt this electric shock in my heart. And at that time, her pain disappeared in her brain and in her heart, and also in her lung and in her pharynx and everything. The pain were all gone. I was restored, and my mind was very clear, and my soul was filled with the light and the love of God. And there's no quotation where it was taken. So you need to experience this electric current in your body. You need to experience the relationship with God. This is Ministry of Healing 115. The love which Christ diffuses through the whole being is a vitalizing power. Every vital part, the brain, the heart, the nerves, it touches with healing. By it, the highest energies of the being are roused to activity. It frees the soul from the guilt and sorrows, the anxiety and care that crush the life forces. With it come serenity and composure. It implants in the soul joy that nothing earthly can destroy, joy in the Holy Spirit, health-giving, life-giving joy. She also mentioned the highest energy there. And Numbers chapter 27, verse 16. Our God is the life of every flesh. Numbers 27, verse 16. And Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 20. There you love your God and obey the law, and He is your life. That's what He says. And Psalms 36, verse 9. And Acts 17, verse 25. And John chapter 1, verse 4, there is life in God, and this life is the light of the people. This is Ministry of Healing 115 that I just read it for you. Ministry of Healing 115.
자, 여기 이제 내재하는 능력이 그들 속에 있다고 믿게.
And Testimonies for the Church, Volume 1, page 294. If Satan can so befog and deceive the human mind as to lead mortals to think that there is an inherent power in themselves to accomplish great and good works, they cease to rely upon God to do for them that which they think there is power in themselves to do. And Education, page 126. The creative energy that called the worlds into existence is in the Word of God. This Word imparts power. It begets life. Every command is a promise accepted by the will, received into the soul. It brings with it the life of the Infinite One. It transforms the nature and recreates the soul in the image of God. When I read this, every command is a promise, I couldn't understand. Command is command. Why is it a promise? I think Ellen G. White understood righteousness by faith. She understood righteousness by faith perfectly. Why? Because she said command is a promise. If you don't understand the righteousness by faith, command is a command and promise is a promise. But because she understood the righteousness by faith, she said every command is a promise. So I thought of this for a long time because I couldn't understand why command can be a promise. You know, Ellen G. White quoted human as a human machine. Now, this machine cannot work by itself when it functions. God should send the energy to make this machine function. So God promised to send this energy to this machine to function. Now, Ellen G. White strongly believe in this process. In the desert, God told Moses to lead them out. And those Israelites actually, they said, we will observe your command. Those people, Israelites in the wilderness, they didn't know that God's command is a command. They didn't know that God's command is a promise. When I study the Bible with the patients, I easily explain this. To emphasize that Ellen G. White is a prophet, I use this metaphor a lot. Is there any theologians say that promise is, I mean, the command is a promise? I think only Ellen G. White could say this command is a promise. Now there is a doctor, let's say there is a doctor called Sang Lee. He's very rich and he's very religious. And he also has this, he also practices a lot of charities. And he helps this orphanage. And now with thousands and thousands of dollars, he went to the orphanage. He donated the money there. And he saw this one orphan. And this boy looked very smart. So Dr. Sang Lee thought he's very smart. So he went to that orphanage many times just to observe this boy. And this boy, you know, has a very good relationship, you know, with his friends. So this doctor went to the official staff and said, does he have any relatives? And the staff says, no, he has no relatives at all. So, you know, Dr. Sang Lee, you know, told him that Dr. Sang Lee decided to have him study hard, support him to make him a doctor. So Sang Lee called this boy, what's your name? And so-and-so. And Dr. Sang Lee also said, well, when you grow up, would you work for God? And this boy said, yes. So Sang Lee said, I think you should become a doctor and a pastor. You know, there's New Start movement. You know, New Start, they teach the Word of God, and they teach that the Word of God heals people. This is amazing movement. So you go to theology, you go to study, you go and study theology and become a doctor. So let's say this Sang Lee ordered or demanded him to be like that. Now, the boy can react in two ways. He said, well, I have no sponsor. I cannot go to that kind of universities. He could say this. And the other one, other answer is, he could say, oh, Sang Lee, thank you very much. When you thank someone, it means you have faith in someone. You trust someone. Now, this boy says, well, you know, I can't do this by myself. I have no sponsor, but you told me to do this way is because you are going to help me. So if this boy sees, if this boy has the faith, then he can believe his command. So here, command is a promise, means this Ellen G. White see the character of God. And that's how she could say that every command is a promise. Some people don't believe in Ellen G. White and her prophetic messages. But I'm so sure that she is a prophet. And again, every command is a promise accepted by the will, received into the soul. It brings with it the life of the infinite one. Now, if you write life in Chinese characters, that is life plus command. So our life in Chinese character translation is like the life and command. God commands us to live. That's life in Chinese characters. So life is a command. So God says, I will let you live. I will let you have life, eternal life. That's a promise. The life that we have, life is command. And a promise for eternal life. Go back to a reading. It transforms the nature and recreates the soul in the image of God. That's education 1-6. Remember command, life, and the character, and the recreation, which is healing. Every words were all in order. When you practice New Start, you see many false healings as well. Sometimes people just get better. That person, they didn't even experience this spiritual thing. And those some people, they, you know, don't come to class, but somehow they didn't study the Bible, but somehow they just get better just because they practice a little bit of New Start. And then I think, Satan is playing. That's false healing. Just because that person took brown rice and vegetarian diet, you know, then that patient thinks, that patient who got better, that patient thinks, so healing is nothing. It's just, you just eat healthy diet and exercise and drink water, that's all. So healing is just nothing. Very easy. I can do this. That's how they think. And that happens in our center sometimes. It's very difficult for me to say, that is good for him or that is bad for him. It's very difficult because that person got better anyway. You know, then that person's choice is very important. Let's say yes, God healed me. If that person thinks that way, that is good. Thank God, you healed me. Because you healed me, I want to meet you. I want to accept you. Then that is a blessing. If that person thinks that way, that's a blessing. But there are not many. Really, not many. Instead, they become proud. They go to their work to make money, and then they drink. Why? Because for them, it's very easy.